Hello, my name is Carol, and this is your step two for restorative shavasana. So if you didn't watch my previous video, we did the head and neck support with either an angled or I call it a bird's nest type fold to a blanket. Today we're going to work on more of the torso support. So say if you're on a hard floor like I am, and also the leg support. There'll be one more video in the series. Like, how much does it take to relax? I get it. The final video will be the arm support, as well as final little suggestions on eye pillows, etc. So let's start with the easiest one, is just padding your space. You honestly don't need to pad the entire length of the mat. What you really need is to support from shoulders to pelvis. So I'm just going to take this a little bit down because my head and neck support will be here. So I'm going to do the staggered blanket. So just right at that edge, making sure it's nice and smooth, even taking the head and neck blanket, maybe just a little bit over. And this will be enough cushioning. So for the legs, if you have low back tightness, soreness, like I usually do, this is going to feel really nice. Of course, if you have any pain in this position, just skip the support underneath your knees and ankles. But there are two ways to do this. So if you don't have bolsters, what you're going to do is take any kind of towel. And actually, I would say take two towels on top of each other, like opening it all out, stacking them, and then rolling them. So you need something fairly large underneath your knees. And then something a little bit smaller, I'm going to show a prana bolster underneath your ankles. It's really the Achilles tendon. So your heels are going to actually float. Restorative yoga, we have the knees about twice as high as the ankles, so just keep that in mind. We're not going to measure it, but just keep that in mind that you're kind of creating a wave like of flexion for the body to relax. So I'll show the bolster options in a second. Hopefully that won't come at me. But basically, if you're going to go with the towel or a blanket, I'll just show you really quick. You go about a third of the way and then you roll really tight, so it creates a tight, solid inner core, and it's just going to be nice. So, this would be, for example, a good ankle support. You need two stacked again to make the knee support. So, I know because I've done this before, shocking, I know. That my prana bolster is amazing, but it is just slightly too low. So I like to just take a folded blanket underneath for a little bit more height, and I kind of fluff it up. So if you have a rectangle bolster, what you're going to do is grab a block and we're going to make an angle. So the angle is done. Let's see. Actually, it's this way. So, taking support so the bolster is on an angle. So, when you lay down, the bolster is going to hit behind your thighs and then the back of your knees. Could I have wore worse colored pants for this? The back of your knees, I'll just point to it, one finger, is on the edge of the bolster. Obviously, now my block is kind of sliding a little bit, but hopefully you can get that in place. If you do not want to use a rectangle bolster and say you invested, these are not cheap. Say you invested in a round bolster and you don't get much use out of it. This is a great place to use it. So I'm going to put that underneath my knees. It's just a nice curve. So let's get into this with moving away, spreading out the flesh, Any excess, so these are pretty tight pants, which I don't recommend for Shavasana, but making sure you have, like, if you have looser pants, that any of the extra fabric is out from behind your knee. And then before you lay down, always make sure that you do this. So we're kind of in a sit-up. Already it's like, oh, I gotta earn relaxing. Just make sure to fluff up your prana bolster. I kind of turn on end. Heels are dangling, just supporting behind the Achilles tendon. And then, I never get this right. I usually end up too close to the, a little too close, that's right. So just manipulate the blanket. And then obviously I'm not gonna show it right now just for time's sake, but you would do the bird nest effect, securing the head and neck and relaxing. And just because we didn't get to part three yet, you just have your arms by your sides. So this is part two of Shavasana. We have a head support underneath the body cushion, and you can even see the nice wave-like effect of the legs to release the low back. It's really nice. To come out of this, I'll always show you and remind you to come out of it slowly. I'm just going to speed it up for time's sake. I'm going to turn so my knees point to the ceiling. I'm going to take 1 foot at a time and rest it on top of the bolster. You could stay here for a few breaths, kind of make it relaxing coming out. You don't want to stay in Shavasana for so long and then pop back up to sitting. And then come onto your side. Your top hand is always going to be the hand to help you up. And take that bottom hand in to help as soon as you can. Letting the head hang as much as you can until you are upright and then the head comes up last. So this is almost there. It looks pretty good, right? All right, so if you have any questions, please email me, let me know. But otherwise, stay tuned for part three of getting into Shavasana.